you have to figure out your rate to give it to the customer, just like fuel. A little bit different than fuel. Okay. Determine your 3-year average of parts spent for each department. Look for trends to make sure there's nothing that's out of usual. They should generally, at the size of the fleet, there's no other little weird anomalies, should be about the same. Maybe a little bit more because of the cost of parts. And then recommend what their parts spent should be for the next fiscal year. We wouldn't follow that times 26% thing because that's what we did last year. So it wouldn't be the same. So here's an example of what the rental rates, whether you do it or not, are submitted to the department. This is what happens in the finance department. They're all sitting around, there's police, fire, here are your rental rates. This is what you need to budget to pay for your cost of these. And it looks something like this. The police department might get, say, hey, I need $1 million, because you have a capital replacement card. I've calculated, and that's what I need this year to pay to the eventual replacement of your vehicles. And here's your labor rate, which Sam's going to talk to more in depth in this presentation. And here's what you need to budget for parts and here's what you need to budget for vehicles. There's a couple of these that are set in stone. Your label and your capital rates. But remember fuel and parts, they had predictors. So, as a fleet manager, during the year, we should check to make sure that our predictions are holding true, especially in fuel. It's very simple to be able to look at the department's fuel and say, all right, I had them using 120,000 gallons of fuel this year, and I'm in June. Their consumption should be somewhere around 60,000. It's just a check to make sure that everything is following what you predicted. And the big one is, I predicted that fuel would average $3.50 a gallon per liter. And it's pretty much held true. Because if your trends are way off, your department and your finance folks, they want to know this in June. They don't want to know it in November.